bring them up in the society, in order to uplift their situation and status in the society, we have adopted certain welfare policy, and we have also adopted positive discrimination in the name of reservation. Here, Andhra Pradesh says that this is actually challenging the principle of merit and equality. He says it is not right, and it is not right on the principle of merit and equality. This will get back India, this will bring India back for many ages, and it will be hampering India in its progress, what Andhra Pradesh says. He says that on the as we have identified caste as an identity and caste as a dimension for bringing people from their uplifting people from their social position, this is not going to be very beneficial. But he has not elaborated much on it. So largely he has understood, Andhra Pradesh has understood and taken up the Trinitarian approach influenced by Weber, and he has taken caste, class and power, which other scholars like G.S. Ghuri or M.N. Srinivas has not talked about. So Andhra Pradesh has specifically talked about social stratification and social inequality from the perspective of caste, class and power nexus. कि हमें इन तीनों को समझने की ज़रूरत है, even village economy को समझने के लिए हमें इन तीनों को समझने की ज़रूरत है कि कैसे ये जो है social exclusion create करता है और कैसे ये social stratification जो है बढ़ाता है हमारे समाज में. So that is what is understanding of Andhra Pradesh over caste, class and power. So thank you so much. We'll continue with the next topic, and that way I'll be taking the effect of globalization and what are the changes which are taking place in our Indian society because of globalization. Thank you.